Hi, thanks so much for coming. There's something else going on today, so I appreciate making the choice to be here. I think the primary question you'd ask candidates is why are they running? And I'm running to save the American dream. My grandparents imprinted on me three fundamental American values, and those are self-reliance, independence, and personal responsibility. And when I look out and see the country and watch TV and see the protests, the violence, the effects of illegal immigration, I see that we've drifted so far from those values, it's time to recenter the country. And I intend to be a willing partner to our president, President Trump. I think we saw him in his speech to the joint session of Congress grow into the role of president, and he outlined 22 promises. There's not a single promise I disagree with. American people want something different. They want to see a change in D.C., and I want to use my 30 years of business experience to change the way we do business in D.C. I don't think you want to send politicians who want to be there for 10 or 20 or 30 years. It's time to send people who want to go to D.C. to do what's right, in spite of what the consequences might be for their own political career. Thank you for coming.
Hi, good afternoon, and thank you again for being here. My name is Keith Grauert. My website is keithforgeorgia.com. And I'm running because we need leaders of courage who are going to stand up to partisan interest and special interest. I grew up in Dunwoody around the corner, actually. My brother went to Dunwoody High School. I graduated from Marist, and then I went to Duke on an Air Force ROTC scholarship. After college, I went to pilot training in the Air Force down in Valdosta, and I lived all over the country and I lived all over the world. I served for a while in South Korea. I served in Eastern Europe for about a year and a half, where I worked extensively with NATO. I've deployed to the Middle East four times, and in that time flew 497 combat sorties in Iraq and Afghanistan. I finished up my career at Andrews Air Force Base, and I'm still in the Air National Guard. And I did all of those things because I believe in the nobility of putting the country first and serving an interest greater than yourself. And that's what I think we're missing in Washington these days. And that's why I want to go to Washington and continue to fight for our country and to fight for you every day. I'm not a wealthy businessman. I'm not a career politician. I'm an ordinary guy who loves America and wants to keep fighting for America. So thank you very much.
Two minutes. That's how long we have to convince you how much we care about the American dream, how to tell you how qualified we are, to tell you how we will fight for what's right, to explain to you what our goals are and what we want to do if we're elected to this position in Congress. I am one of the five, my name is Richard Keeley, I'm one of the five Democratic candidates on the ticket here for this office. I was not born into privilege. I do not have a huge campaign war chest. It's just me, people who love, respect, and have backed me, fighting for the American dream. I was born into a working class family. I made it on my own. I went to college on an ROTC scholarship. I served my country as an officer in the United States Navy from 1987 to 1994. Where I learned the importance of America's diversity, the importance of America's leadership role in the world. After that, I became an educator and have taught at Georgia State University, teaching Italian and French, helping students achieve their dream of studying abroad. I will, if elected to Congress, fight for the values that I learned growing up. I was born in a working class family. My father worked in a factory until last year. I know what it means to struggle. That's why I will fight for working class people. I will fight for students. I will fight for the seniors who have already paid their fair share. I served in the military. That's why I will serve our veterans and keep our nation safe. I have taught in a public university. That's why I will fight for public education. If you vote for me, I will be a strong leader for the 6th District. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Muhammad Ali, the lightweight. But if you do vote for me and if I'm elected, I'll fight like heavyweight in Washington, D.C. I came to this country in 1986. Ronald Reagan was president. It took me 14 years to become citizen of this great country, and I did it the right way. I will touch on this during the Q&A, but I have limited time now. I was termed by a number of sources the best qualified candidate in this race, with PhD in economics, two MBAs, 30 years of professional experience, traveling more than 50 countries around the world, understand complex economic, political, social, cultural issues, which are critical for a congressman to deal with, $20 trillion debt, complex foreign policy issues, war, whatever we are talking about. I strongly believe that we must keep our promise to our citizens, the senior citizens. They have done their share, so we should save Social Security and Medicare, and it can be easily done. There is a plan I have. Climate change is real. We must do everything possible. To save people and planet both. I'm also big on youth and women empowerment because I strongly believe empowered women can raise a better child, and empowered child can become a better citizen and better leader to take our country forward. Thank you. I believe world peace is possible if we do our part and give back to our community, and that is precisely why I'm running. Thank you so much.
My name is David Abrams, and just to tell you real briefly about me, I'm a CPA, then became an entrepreneur. I started a business converting vehicles to run on clean domestic natural gas. Yes, Republicans do care about the environment as well. It was a successful business. I was able to invest in my campaign. And I decided to do this because I see a broken political system. I see America in big trouble. We are seeing in this election outside influencers coming in and deciding for the people who they should vote for and who should represent the 6th District in Congress. And it's very disturbing to me. On the Democrat side, you have Nancy Pelosi and you have the Democrat Party choosing who voters should support on the Democratic side. And then what do we do in response? We put out, or not we, the Republicans in Washington, they put out ads accusing someone else running in this race for being tied to Osama bin Laden. It's disgraceful, it's disgusting, it's everything that's wrong with politics, and we need to get these special interests out of our politics. They are using the 6th District as a political football so that they can maintain their power in Washington, D.C. I'm fed up with it. I'm sick of it. I'm going to stand up to whatever and whoever is wrong in Washington, even if it's my own party. And I'm going to stand up for the people of the 6th District. I'm going to stand up for voters. Thank you very much. I hope I can count on your support.
David. Folks, I consider this a job interview. I'm Dan Moody, and I want to earn your vote today. And I want to tell you that I'm ready for the hard work, because that's what it's going to take to get this country back on the right track. I'd like my family to stand up, just real quickly, all of you. My wife, Stephanie, 47 years. She's been my best friend that length of time. My daughter, Tiffany. We got Emily, Matthew, Allie, and Jack, her kids, and husband Jack in the back. Thanks for coming. Folks, back in 2002, I was first elected to the state senate. And I'm sure some of you remember those days, because that's back when Fran Millar, Dan Weber, and I started the path to create the city of Dunwoody. We did all the cities in North Fulton. Dunwoody was another one. And what a difference it's made. Back in 2002, when I first got elected to the state Senate, Georgia had just started to turn red. And a lot of heavy lifting had to be done. And it was like a dog catching a car. A lot of folks didn't really understand what governing was like, and new leaders started to emerge. and I was one of them. I had served in the Army as an officer. I'd been in business since the early 70s. I'd owned my own business and created some great jobs in Georgia. Created a business worth millions of dollars to the economy. And in the state Senate, I did my share of the hard work. But at the end of the day, I had always believed in term limits. So I term limited myself. I went back home to live under the laws I helped create. Today in Washington, we've got those same challenges. It's time to get to work. I'd love to earn your vote.
Hello, I'm Ron Slodin. I want to tell you about my background and why I'm running for Congress. I was born and raised in Atlanta, went to North Fulton High School, went to the University of Georgia, came out and worked at Portman Properties. I then ran for the state Senate and was elected in my first run for public office. When I was in the state Senate, we actually got things done. I was on the Education Committee when we passed the HOPE Scholarship. That's the best program that's ever been passed in this state. We also cut taxes, gave teachers the pay raise they deserved, balanced the budget, and grew the economy. But just as important, when I was in the state Senate, I have a record of working across the aisle with Republicans and legislators from all around the state to get legislation passed to get real results for the people of Georgia. And when I travel to the district, that's the biggest problem we have now. The fighting, the bickering, the gridlock in Washington, nothing's getting done. We have real issues in our community that need to be addressed. And I know this because I live, work, owned a business, raised my family, and volunteer in the 6th District for over 15 years. My kids attend public school at Lassiter High School. I'm a member of the PTA. My mom lives in Dunwoody. I've been active, a volunteer coach at the Marcus Jewish Community Center for years. So I'm very active, invested in this community. After politics, I opened an advertising agency in Sandy Springs. I helped start the Sandy Springs Chamber of Commerce. When I was with my ad agency, I was part of the four-person business development team that created the 2009 entertainment tax credits. Have you seen all the movie and TV productions going on in the state? That's because of these tax credits. There was even a film, they filmed several movies in Dunwoody. You might have seen Billy Crystal and Bette Midler walking around the neighborhood. But 2016 alone, there was over 240 movie and TV productions that created over $7 billion worth of economic development. So I'm running on the local issues, I'm running to create jobs, support our schools, and fix transportation problems. On the national level, I'm going to protect Social Security and Medicare. We're going to protect clean air and water. We're going to defend a woman's right to control her own health care decisions. We're going to make it. Go ahead. I'm Ron Slodin. I'm passionate about this community. I'm passionate about getting results. I ask for your vote. Thank you.
Good afternoon, I'm Karen Handel. Thank you all so much for being here. You could have been a lot of other places. It's beautiful outside and we do have that little thing going on called the Masters. So I appreciate that you made time to come out today. We have a lot of talk going on in Washington. Republicans have talked for 8 years about everything that they're going to do. It's now time to deliver. And in the elected roles that I've had the privilege to serve, I've delivered for the Fulton County and for the state time and time again. My background, my career is anchored in the private sector, having held executive positions with KPMG and CIBA Vision. I served as CEO of the North Fulton Chamber of Commerce, taking that organization quite literally from the brink of bankruptcy back to solvency, while also creating tens of thousands of jobs, helping to create those jobs here in the North Metro area. When I was given the privilege of serving as Fulton County Commission Chairman, I inherited a $100 million budget deficit. No one thought that I would be able to balance that budget without tax increases, but I did, and I did it without a Republican majority. When I had the privilege of being Secretary of State, I was able to get photo ID implemented in a fair and appropriate way across our state so that we would have strong voter protections at the ballot box. We need to have our next congressman be someone who understands the community and the local issues, someone who will be a fighter for you. We need to repeal and replace Obamacare, jumpstart this economy so that we can lower taxes, create more jobs, get wages back to where they need to be, higher paying jobs. We also need someone who can work well with your local elected officials. Today marks the 19th anniversary of the devastating tornado that ripped through this community, creating so much loss. It's important to have someone who knows your mayor, who knows your council members, Terry, and always I'm grateful to have his support. We need to have someone who's going to be a fighter for you and not beholden to others. I'm running for Congress because I want to be that person to represent you and fight for you. I look forward to the questions and earning your vote. Thank you so much.
Good evening, everyone. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Andre Pollard, and I'm running for Congress. I am a technologist, and I am part of what you would consider the resist movement. I'm one of the people that, you know, was watching TV, and I couldn't watch anymore, and I had to get up off the couch. When the Muslim ban got the first time we got enacted, and it took Google, Facebook, Amazon, and 100+ companies to come out against the Muslim ban, and our congressional representative in Washington, quiet, not a peep. I knew that we, the technologists, do not have the proper representation in Congress. And that's why I have been very blessed in my life, decided to get up and do something about it. I am an immigrant. I came to this country when I was 10 years old. I married to a Latino, so half my household is Spanish speaking. I run the Alpharetta Ventures and Incubator Meetup Group. I run the Alpharetta Rails Coders with free website development classes on Saturday. You'll be surprised at all the people that show up at that, old, young, everyone. I started the Alpharetta Ionic 2 Mobile Development. Again, I'm pushing technology, and I have a lot of technology solutions. I've been doing this for over 4 years, so when you hear candidates talking about Silicon Valley of the South, I've already been doing that for 4 years. I'm a father of four, two teenagers, a four-year-old and a one-year-old, and basically, I am you. I am representing all of you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, my name is Bruce Lavelle, and thanks for coming out. And shouts out to Dick Williams here with the Dunwoody Crier. Let's give him a hand. Locally owned newspaper, which we should all go out and buy, support small business. My wife and I, we're a family owned business right here in Dunwoody on Ashford Dunwoody Road. It's called Dunwoody Diamonds USA. Some of y'all are wearing some of our engagement rings and nice little trinkets. Everybody raise your hand. The whole crowd raised their hand. I see a few. No, but thank you for patronizing us. But I attend North Point Church. My home is in Sandy Springs by the beautiful Chattahoochee River. And my business is, like I said, is right here in the city of Dunwoody. My beautiful wife is right here. Stand up, honey. Stand up. How beautiful you are. Isn't she awesome? And, my daughter, Leah, is her last year at University of Maryland. She attended Marist, and she currently works in the West Wing with Sean Spicer. My son attends Auburn University, go War Eagles, his freshman year football. Thank you, Amy, go War Eagles. Why I'm in this race, you know, like many of you, I suffered a catastrophic inconvenience, as you say, in my household with government overreach, bank loans being called for no reason. A lot of things I've heard a lot of us in this room, and thank God, hopefully we'll rebound for that. I want to be that champion to fight for you. How I can fight for you is the fact that no one owns me. I've totally disavowed all special interest groups, all PACs, no lobby money. Thank you. Y'all know how important that is. If you go to the FEC, you can see all these candidates, and you can find out where all the money's coming from. And you'll see who owns the candidate. They don't own Bruce Lavelle. Just remember that. That's a powerful asset to go to DC, guys, to fight for you. I was currently chairman at MARTA for 5 years, and 3 years I was chairman of operations. I think I can take a heavy lift. I was Donald Trump's top surrogate for years. I still do White House surrogate work. I think I can take that relationship and bring this worst traffic that we have in our corridor, that I know I can help mitigate some of this mess that we have. Bruce Lavelle, LavelleForCongress.com. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Alexander Hernandez, and I'm proud to be the only truly independent candidate in a field of 18 candidates. Meaning, I've already put the district before any money, special, or party interests, because the district is who I want to represent, not anyone else. I'm a working class candidate. My parents, my mom is a hairdresser, my dad was a steel worker, and they instilled in me these values, our Christian faith, and to work hard in pursuit of the American dream, and that's what I've done ever since. I got into this race because I knew that issues important to working folks were going to be ignored had I not participated, and we're seeing that. Issues involving the income inequality in this country have been silenced, except for this campaign. We've been focusing on what matters, Social Security and Medicare, because that's our money and it needs to be there when we need it. I'm focusing on a plan that is an economic plan that gets the stimulus out of our economy, and we start by investing in people. The way we do that is today we invest in infrastructure for jobs, and then we invest in education for future growth. We need to make sure that every school in this country is the best possible school, and that way we will keep up with the changing times, and we keep up, and that's what we need. That's a bare minimum. And then I have a plan that focuses on our veterans. Taking care of our veterans by giving them a raise, how do you pay for it? You go to the Pentagon and find over $6.5 trillion that's been lost over there over the last 10 years. No one's talked about the Pentagon. No one wants to audit the Pentagon. And that's absurd that we have people in Congress who are supposed to check the purse, and they don't do that. I want to go to Washington and check the purse again, making sure we hold the people who lose our money accountable and start diverting funds to our men and women in service as a thank you. And always looking through what can we do for the people first. What's going to benefit all of us as the baseline, and we build from there. My name is Alexander Hernandez, and my website is yourvotegeorgia.com, and I hope I can count on y'all's support. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for being here today. I'm Amy Kramer, and I want to thank the Dunwoody Homeowners Association for putting this event together. I have to say that it's more than the 6th District GOP can do, because they have not been able to hold one event that has had all 11 GOP candidates there, and that's disgraceful, honestly. I am a lifelong resident of the district. I was born in Kennestone Hospital, graduated from Lassiter High School, and I went to this little school over in Alabama, War Eagle, for a time. Came back here to Atlanta, was a real estate agent and Delta Airlines flight attendant. I too, like Mr. Pollard, was sick and tired of yelling at my TV and radio and got off my couch and decided to do something about it, but it was about 8 or 9 years ago, and I'm one of the founders of the modern day Tea Party movement. Now, I'm not an extremist. I'm not the party of no or complete opposition all the time. What I want is I want Washington to work for we the people again. I think that Washington has gotten out of control. Most people go there with the best of intentions, but what happens? They become beholden to the special interests and the money that flows through Washington, and they no longer represent us. I don't think our founding fathers intended for people to go to Washington and to live there for 20, 30, 40 years, almost to their deathbed. There are people that have been there longer than I've been alive, and that's not acceptable. So I got involved in politics because I truly wanted to affect change. I think everybody says there's no silver bullet to fix healthcare. Well, I think there is a silver bullet. You make Washington live under the same rules as you and I and all Americans, it'll get fixed real quick. I too believe that we need tax reform, we need to repeal and replace Obamacare, I'm concerned about our national security. Those are all things that we're gonna hear everybody up here talk about today. But at the end of the day, if the people aren't going to Washington and doing what they promised to do, then we're not going to get anywhere. I'm Amy Kramer, and I'd love to have your vote. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Judson Hill, and I'm thankful that y'all are here, and we're blessed to have this opportunity to visit with you today. America has a unique opportunity to change the course and get us back on the right track. And I think this election is all about trust. Which one of these individuals do you really trust? Who's pretending and who's not? Who's got the proven track record? The difference between everybody else, frankly, and me, is I've got a proven track record of working hard to create jobs, lowering your health care, and working hard to lower your health care costs across the state, and also standing up for conservative principles. It's that simple. We've worked hard to lower your tax burden across on each one of you, and it's that simple. A strong economy, a strong military, and protecting your conservative values, because I believe that the best predictor of what someone's going to do is what they've already done, right? So if you're going to have someone tell you what they're going to do, at least have them show you what they've already done. Make them show you what they've already done. With me, you've got a man of deep faith, a strong courage, and strong integrity. You've got a conservative reformer, a proven, experienced track record of not just talking about this, but this very same year working hard for you in the Georgia Senate to do just that, help make health care more affordable for you. I've served in the Georgia Senate for 12 years. I worked for President Reagan. I've been a United States attorney. Different things along the way, but I'm a small businessman and done that for the last 15 years. I know where you live. I know what's important to you because I'm one of you. So if you want someone who's going to stand strong in their principles, elect me, because I have a proven record of standing up for against the political establishment, the special interest. I got punished. I had a chairmanship taken away by this someone on this group here. I've had a chairmanship taken away. I've had been stuck in the corner. But you can't. You can tell me where to sit, but you'll never be able to tell me where to stand. And it's always with you. I promise to stand with you. I pledge to. And if you elect me, we're going to win again. I have for 7 times in a row. Thank you very much. I appreciate y'all being here.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you to the Homeowners Association. Thank you, Dick and Robert, for moderating. My name is John Ossoff. I was born and raised in Metro Atlanta, grew up in the 6th Congressional District in North DeKalb County, not too far from here. Went to Georgetown University's School of Foreign Service, where I studied international relations. I worked on Capitol Hill for 5 years, specializing in defense and national security policy. I saw how things work in Congress, but more than that, I saw how they do not. I saw the partisanship and the gridlock, the pettiness and the corruption. And I ultimately decided to leave. In 2012 and 2013, I got a master's degree from the London School of Economics. And I now run a small business that specializes in investigations of organized crime, political corruption, and war crimes around the world. We produce documentary films for international television broadcasters and news organizations. And I had no plans to get back into politics anytime soon. But the last 6 months have changed my worldview pretty profoundly. I think it's time for fresh leadership in Washington. Fresh leadership focused less on the endless partisan negativity that's drowning us in nonsense, and real results instead. The economic potential of our region here is virtually unlimited. We've got the busiest airport in the world, a deep water port in Savannah, a booming tech sector, especially in North Metro Atlanta. 600 tech companies around Alpharetta alone, nearly 200,000 people employed in high-tech economy in Metro Atlanta. And yet, instead of discussing what we can do to deliver the kind of solutions necessary to grow this economy into an economic powerhouse, that's the envy of the rest of the country, we remain mired in gridlock, partisanship, negativity. I'm running a positive campaign that's focused on our shared prosperity, how we can grow this economy so families have more opportunity, higher incomes, more affordable college, and a better quality of life. And I think that that is a message that can cross party lines. I ask for your support on April 18th. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Kirk Wilson, and I have some bad news and some good news. The bad news is that Robert reported that this rank of order here was not according to polling data. So the bad news is that John is now 14th in the polling data, and I'm 15th, just so that you know. Give me a straight scoop on the story here. The other good news is I can tell you that I have got to meet and know most of these 17 other candidates up here. And I will tell you, they're fine Americans. They're good people. They're honest people. They care. They want to do the right thing. And I can also tell you that most of the people that we elect to the United States House of Representatives and the United States Senate, a large majority of those people are good people. So what's wrong? What's the problem? And the reality is that we keep chasing shiny objects, because what we really need at this point is the growth of government has gotten so large that you and I both know as regular citizens, it's breaking our backs. We also know something probably that we don't want to admit to ourselves, that we've gotten to a place that the founders were worried about, that where we've gotten to a place that where special interest and factions have taken over our government. And so it's no longer about D's and R's, it's about incumbency. It's about special interest. And so I tell you, as a normal citizen, an ordinary citizen who's never been in politics, why in the world would you do this? because it's time ordinary people start standing up and changing our government again. And the first way we're going to do that was with a constitutional amendment to term limits, my friends. Whether you're Republican or Democrat, we have to do it. Because we can't focus on the foremost important things to me that are in front of us that if we don't deal with are going to destroy our country. We have to reverse the $20 trillion of national debt. We have to balance the budget every year. We have to repeal the 16th Amendment. And we have to derail and devolve the federal bureaucracy. My name is Kurt Wilson. I appreciate your support on April 18th. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. How's everyone doing today? Good, good. My name is Reagan Edwards. It's actually spelled R-A-G-I-N. Edwards is spelled correct. And I'm a professional and a mother. I actually graduated from high school right in the 6th District in East Cobb at Pope High. And then I went to Georgia Tech with the Hope Scholarship. Thanks for watching. I then moved up to Washington, D.C. and worked for a presidential appointee named Philip Mangano, who was actually appointed under George W. Bush. And that was my first mission, try to eradicate homelessness in America. After that, I had a stint at the Department of Energy under the civil rights lawyers. And then when I started a family, I decided to move to the best place in America, and that was back to the 6th District. You know, I've always been a political junkie ever since I was a kid, but I've protested and I have worked on different campaigns, you know, with my friends and trying to get younger people to vote. And I decided that it was time for me to take my turn and make my voice heard for the people. Because what we need in Congress are average people that have a heart for the people. And that's who I am. I come from a history of people that have fought for education and civil rights all the way from my great-great-grandfather to my grandmother to my mother, who was a woman that was in corporate America that made strides that helped other minorities have a voice. So I'm here today to tell you that the only way Americans can take back America is to make sure that there is truth and transparency in government and to use the tools that we already have to make sure this happens. My name is Reagan Edwards. Thank you for your time.
William Locke, my condolences to Phineas Hawk's family and friends and the entire Dunwoody community. We have a history in the 6th District of sending experts in their field to Congress. I am that expert in taxes and regulations. I'm a small business owner. I started a CPA firm right here in the 6th District over 30 years ago, born and raised right here, consulting business owners and individual taxpayers. I am completely aware of how middle-income Americans are paying the most tax, and I have a clear understanding of how the income tax code needs to be changed to make us successful. Also, what is important to me is education. As a father of two middle school students, this is a subject I care deeply about. Public education needs to be in the hands of the educators and local governments, and I am for school choice. On the college level, student loan debt is at $1.3 billion and counting. The government needs to step up and stop predatory lending. On the stance of a fair wage, I agree that an increase is needed to $9.70 an hour. Big corporations are taking advantage of the government assistance with their employees. This is corporate welfare, and we need to get these employers off the government payroll and give self-respect back to the people. I'm the middle brother of 11 siblings. With 62% Republican and 38% Democrats, my family, as well as our district, our dinner conversations get quite problematic. Yet in the end, an agreement is reached satisfactory to both sides. I need your vote to send me to Congress to represent you and facilitate the changes in the tax code that will support our business owners and middle-income taxpayers. We have enough congressmen supporting corporations, large corporations. Go to my website, LOP. Thank you. 2 and 10.
My name is Dr. Rebecca Quigg. First of all, I do want to extend my condolences about Phineas' death over the spring break. It's very sad to lose someone in the community at such a young age. I live in Cobb County, and my son is graduating from Pope High School, so I've been here many times. My son's a member of the Georgia Fencing League, and we've been to tournaments here and all over the district, and he's also a member of the competition marching band. So I've spoken to parents, families, relatives, friends, neighbors, all over about the issues in this district. And of course, one of the most important things is our public high schools. We need to make sure that we have the best K through 12 education, and we need to make sure that our children can go to college debt-free. That's very important to me, and I will fight for those when I go to Congress. I'm a cardiologist, and my last position was as the director of heart failure transplant at Northwestern as associate professor of medicine. I'm a lifelong educator, and I mentored thousands of medical students, residents, and cardiology fellows, and trained them how to deal with patients so critically ill that they needed a heart transplant. During my time there, I published extensively peer-reviewed literature, and I lectured all over the world. Healthcare is a very important issue. And what I see is that we need someone in Congress that will work in a bipartisan way to make what we have better, expand it, and extend it to all Americans so that we all have coverage. We cannot take Medicare away from people that paid into their entire life and give them a $200 voucher a month, and then next year it's $100, and maybe a year after $50. This is essential. Americans need to have health care. What I have found during my career is that you must work as a team, and I developed a multidisciplinary team that cared for thousands of critically ill patients. And when a family gave the gift of life, several surgeons tried to get the organs for their critically ill patients. And if I can navigate that, I certainly can navigate whatever party is discussing what issue in Congress. Thank you.